I will next play some Weiss. Sylvius Leopold Weiss was a friend of Bach. We know of at least one fortnight where they lived together in the same house and did a lot, made a lot of music together. Weiss was a lute player born almost lived almost exactly the same years as Bach did. And he was the last of the great Baroque lute players. And whereas the Roberto Vise music was written for a Baroque guitar, which is basically an instrument somewhat like this with five strings, strung similar to the guitar, Weiss was playing an instrument quite different than this. It had up to 24 strings. It was tuned in D minor like this, and then had many basses. And it died out basically soon after Weiss played it, for a couple of reasons. One was its complexity. It was just so difficult to play that few people could play it. The other was that the style of music changed and it wasn't really right for the new style. I've listed a whole suite of Weiss, and I'm going to play a few movements from that suite, but also instead a couple of top 40 pieces from Weiss. So I will begin with a Bourée from the suite. You may have noticed that there's some similar movement titles in this Weiss music as there was in de Vise. Although this music was written just 35 years later, it is no longer danced at this time. This was sort of stylized movements. So I'll play a Bourée and an Allemande from the suite, and then a very famous fantasy that Weiss wrote. And I'll end the first part of the program with one of his greatest pieces, called Tombeau, c'est la mort de Monsieur de Comte de Logy. It is an elegy for a lute patron, a count, who funded and befriended all the lute players of the time. When he died, it said that all the lute players put their instruments down for a week. They wouldn't play. And then they all wrote him tombeaus when they started to play again. They were elegies for Weiss. So again, this will be Bourée, Allemande, Fantasy, and a Tombeau.